Okay students, now we will study about stereochemical aspects of nucleophilic substitution reaction. What is meant by stereochemistry? Stereo means arrangement, that is three-dimensional arrangement of groups in a molecule is called as stereochemistry. So in order to study stereochemistry, we have to study some terms. They are, first one, plane polarized light. And optical activity. What is meant by plane polarized light? We know ordinary light, that is our bulb light, it passes through, it rotates, it scatters, it spreads in all possible directions. But when this light is passed through, this is ordinary light. This ordinary light rotates in all possible planes. It vibrates in all possible planes. But this is ordinary light. Ordinary light. This vibrates in all possible planes. But when this light is passed through a Nicol prism. Nicol prism. What is meant by this Nicol prism? It is the prism devised by a chemist by name Nicol in order to get plane polarized light. When this ordinary light is passed through a Nicol prism, the emerging light vibrates only in one plane. This emerging light vibrates only in one plane. This light which vibrates only in one plane is called as plane polarized light. This is plane polarized light. So when this plane polarized light is passed through an aqueous solution of a compound, this is aqueous solution of a compound. When this aqueous solution of compound, when this light is passed through, when plane polarized light is passed through an aqueous solution of a compound, if this emerging light rotates only, it passes without any rotation, without any deflection, this compound is said to be optically inactive. This is optically inactive. But when this compound rotates this plane polarized light, it may rotate the plane polarized light, this compound may rotate the plane polarized light to the right direction or to the left direction. If this compound rotates the plane polarized light, then this compound is said to be optically active. So, some compounds have the ability to rotate the plane polarized light. Such compounds are called as optically active compounds. And this property is called as optical activity. So, you understood plane polarized light? Plane polarized light means when ordinary light is passed through a Nicol prism, the emerging light vibrates only in one plane, that is called as plane polarized light. When the plane polarized light is passed through an aqueous solution of a compound, if the emerging light passes without any deflection, then the compound is optically inactive. If this compound rotates the plane polarized light, then that compound is said to be optically active compound. If it rotates, if it passes without any rotation, that is optically inactive. If it rotates the plane polarized light, then that compound is called optically active compound. That means some compounds have the ability to rotate the plane polarized light. Such compounds are called as optically active compounds, and this process is called as optical activity. Now, next term this compound, this the angle by which this plane polarized light is rotated is measured by using an instrument that is called as polarimeter. The angle by which this plane polarized light is rotated by using a rotated is measured by using a polarimeter. Now, the compound which rotates the plane polarized light towards the right direction or clockwise direction, then that compound is called as dextrorotatory compound. What is meant by dextrorotatory? The compound which rotates the plane polarized light towards the right direction or clockwise direction is called as dextrorotatory compound. It is denoted by D form or plus. Example for dextrorotatory compound is D-lactic acid. Example, D-lactic acid. D-lactic acid. Next, what is meant by levorotatory compound? Levorotatory compound. The compound which rotates the plane polarized light towards left direction or in the anti-clockwise direction is called as levorotatory compound. It is denoted by L form or minus. Example, L-lactic acid. L-lactic acid. Let us draw the structures of D-lactic acid and L-lactic acid. So, lactic acid it is. So, COOH, COOH, H, CH3. This is D-lactic acid. L-lactic acid is, this is a D-lactic acid. Next is L-lactic acid, COOH, COOH, H, CH3. This is L-lactic acid. Now, let us read what our next term is. The second term is optical isomerism. Optical isomerism. See, compounds having same molecular formula, same structural formula, that means they have same physical properties also, but they differ in their action towards plane polarized light. That means they differ in the rotation of plane polarized light. Compounds having same molecular formula and same structural formula, but differ in the action, in their action towards plane polarized light, are called optical isomers. And this phenomenon is called as optical isomerism. So, examples for optical isomers, D-lactic acid and L-lactic acid are optical isomers. So, next is third one, chiral carbon. Chiral carbon. What is meant by chiral carbon? We know carbon is tetrahedral. So, the carbon atom which is attached to four different groups. If this is H, chlorine, bromine, iodine, if it is attached. So, carbon atom which is attached to four different groups is called as chiral carbon. It is represented by an asterisk mark on the carbon. So chiral carbon. It is also called as asymmetric carbon or chiral, this is stereocenter. Chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon or stereocenter. The carbon atom which is attached to, which is bonded to four different groups is called as chiral carbon. Next is chiral molecule. The molecule which contains chiral carbon is called as chiral molecule. The molecule which contains chiral carbon is called as chiral molecule or asymmetric molecule. Or asymmetric molecule. Now, this is an asymmetric molecule, or this also lactic acid is also an asymmetric molecule because this carbon is a chiral carbon because it is attached to four different groups. Now, what is meant by symmetric molecule or achiral molecule? Achiral molecule. The molecule which do not contain chiral carbon is called as achiral molecule or symmetric molecule. The molecule which do not contain chiral carbon is called achiral or symmetric molecule. Now, what are the conditions for a molecule to be a chiral molecule or a symmetric molecule? The conditions for a molecule to be asymmetric are: the molecule should contain chiral carbon. It should contain chiral carbon. And the second condition is, asymmetric molecule do not contain plane of symmetry. That molecule should not contain, do not contain plane of symmetry. Plane of symmetry. What is meant by plane of symmetry? Plane of symmetry means an imaginary plane which divides the molecule into two equal halves is called as the plane of symmetry. Next term we study is plane of symmetry. Plane of symmetry means an imaginary plane which divides the molecule into two equal halves. For example, let us consider methane molecule. In methane, carbon is attached to four hydrogen atoms. If we consider any plane, let us consider plane passing through this carbon, hydrogen, carbon and hydrogen. This plane divides this molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, this plane is called as plane of symmetry. If we consider another molecule containing three same groups, for example, hydrogen, three hydrogen atoms are same, and this chlorine if we consider. If we consider this plane as the imaginary plane, that is, this will be the plane of symmetry because it divides the molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, carbon if attached to three same groups, then also it is a symmetric molecule. It contains plane of symmetry. Now, if we consider, if carbon is attached to two similar groups, then that is hydrogen, chlorine, bromine, if we consider this molecule, this we can consider as the imaginary plane because this plane divides the molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, this is the plane of symmetry. Therefore, this molecule is also a achiral molecule, that is symmetric molecule. This is, it is not an asymmetric molecule. So, for a molecule to be here, if we consider this one, this is contains chiral carbon, therefore this is an asymmetric molecule. Because if we consider any plane, it does not divide the molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, this do not contain plane of symmetry and it contains chiral carbon. Therefore, this molecule is a chiral molecule or asymmetric molecule.